Honorable Ministers, Honorable Deputy Ministers, Senior Government Officials, Members of the Diplomatic Corps, Officials of the EDB, Friends, Ladies and Gentlemen, I am honored to address you today, and I am also delighted that Brandix has been recognized for its achievements in export promotion. I have often mentioned that I always keep on thanking the Export Development Board, because that's where I went. It's through the board that I went on my first apparel marketing mission. And most of my colleagues in the industry, leading exporters today, also enjoyed the benefits of the services provided by the Export Development Board. And they joined me in thanking the board for its services right through from the 1980s. So thank you. In the recent past, the EDB, among other things, has focused on promoting the SME sector. They have arranged customer visits, visits to technical shows to enhance the capability of the SME sector of Sri Lanka. They have refrained from funding the large companies, but focused all their efforts on the SME. And it has been very successful. I am sure going forward, the potential leaders of exports in Sri Lanka will be those companies who are working with the EDB today. I met a friend of mine when I came in. He bought over a foreign, he was an SME company, he ran an SME company and bought over a foreign socks manufacturer and is a large exporter to the EU today. And he definitely is a recipient, because I am personally aware of all the support from the EDB. So we on and off hear many complaints about the EDB, that they are ineffective, they are inefficient, and they do nothing. So I can assure you that the apparel industry does not share that view. I have spoken to most of the leaders of the industry before I spoke today, and we believe that the misconception comes from the fact that people really don't understand what the role of the EDB is. Now, they can provide services, make contacts, B2B, for apparel companies. Let me give you an example. A couple of months ago, some of our members have been trying to contact a large Spanish retailer, and they have not been successful. They were finding it difficult to get a meeting at the right level. They were being pushed around to some regional office. So we asked the EDB for support, and they arranged a meeting at the highest level in Spain, and the companies who were interested went over and met with the right levels. Now, whether these companies get orders or not depends on how good they are. So we cannot take the EDB as a salesman, but as a marketing organization and as a facilitating organization. So I urge my colleagues in the private sector to use the EDB, push them hard as you can, and I'm sure the results will be great. I also urge the government to fund the EDB and so that they can acquire talent wherever there are gaps, because definitely they could do with better talent to push for industries which they are not used to, like electronics and everything else. So I'm sure if the Honorable Minister releases the funds, unfortunately Minister Bathudin is not here, but I am sure Honorable Malik Samaravikrama can do the needful. Now, we as a country will record about $11 billion of exports this year, which is an embarrassingly small amount, because if you compare ourselves to smaller countries, Singapore is $257 billion, Finland is at 78 billion. Malaysia has touched 258 billion. So our 11 billion is, I'm sure the other ministers mentioned that earlier. So what I believe is we should target at least a 25 billion number within the next 5 years. However, the problem is just by announcing these numbers, we won't get there. We will have to have investment on the ground and a plan to achieve that. My suggestion is that if we keep track and publish our numbers monthly on the investment that is going into the ground and the quantum and the date of employment to be generated as per those projects is published, I am sure we will be able to achieve at least 90% of what we plan. Otherwise, it will be only a prayer. So we will work with the government. I have spoken to the new chairman of the Joint Apparel Association Forum. And for the apparel industry, we are very keen that we tie in, sir, with your efforts so that we reach targeted exports on a monthly basis. Now, do we have the resources? There is a constant complaint that the country does not have resources. I believe that we have resources such as land, infrastructure, human capital, and we have a number of highly underdeveloped areas in the country. I just printed out a map. I'm sure most of you won't be able to see it, but this is printed, published by the Department of Census and Statistics. And this shows red is poverty, yellow is no better, pink is just better than red, and yellow is slightly better than the pink. So most of the country, honorable ministers, is not in great shape. But that there lies the opportunity, because we can, if we go into those areas, as some of us have done, those areas are the ideal places to set up various different type of industries, because the labor is available, land is cheap and available in plenty, because the density of population in those areas is quite sparse. So I believe we have the resources. In addition to that, we have a million, almost a million young women working in the Middle East for a couple of $100. I always mention that, and some people don't agree with me, but I think it's a shame for us in the private sector to let our women folk go to the Middle East and work there for about $200 to $300, because we as a private sector have failed to generate jobs which pay that amount of money. So I think the onus is on us now that so many new policies are coming into operation. Let's see whether we can deliver. We have to. Another bigger opportunity than direct exports is to tap into the huge pool of manpower and raw material which is in our immediate neighborhood, that is India, Pakistan, Bangladesh. If we consider ourselves as the front end, we have a massive amount, almost 1.5 billion people, massive amount of cotton, and other resources. Now, if we tap into those resources, I think we can bring in several million dollars of foreign exchange into this country. There are many examples, people already doing that, but we should have a strategy and drive that and track the annual the amount that comes as foreign exchange annually through these special vehicles, instead of confusing it with direct exports. Finally, just before I came up, everybody was asking me whether I would like to talk for 45 minutes. I have assured them that I won't. So I would end by this. We in the apparel sector are extremely bullish about our sector, and I would like to mention that last week, or the week before last, juststyle.com, which is a very prestigious site, a website dealing with the apparel industry published a report, and they had segmented the exporters into the USA into three buckets: winners, stuck in the middle, and losers. Now, out of the winners were Vietnam, obviously, India, and guess who? Sri Lanka. So Sri Lanka, just 2 weeks ago, by a very reputed website, Export in the USA, by studying the statistics — it was not just by whim or fancy, but it's by looking at the numbers — they have designated Sri Lanka's apparel industry as a winner. So the apparel industry, sirs, has always delivered, and I am confident that we will continue to do so. Thank you very much.